There is no instance of police brutality where it isn't a needless tragedy, but some really stand out for just how truly horrific they are. We have a case here that happened in Pennsylvania where there was gunfire on Sunday in the parking lot of a Walmart. Okay, Rashaun Smith was hit and was apparently down, bleeding from the abdomen. Kenneth Vinyard rushed to Rashaun Smith's side while he was laying bleeding on the ground. Paramedics arrived. Vinyard had been trying to help out Rashaun during that time. Then apparently Vinyard stepped away to allow them to do their job. A man in plain clothes, who you will find out ended up being a cop, although not visibly identified as such, demanded that he get further away from the victim. He tried to explain that he was just trying to help out. So the plain clothes police officer struck him, pushed him away. He fell, hit his head on the pavement, and he died. He was a literal good Samaritan. He saw someone get shot, and rather than doing what almost every one of us would have done, which is to run away as fast as you can to protect your own life, he decided, I'm gonna go help that person, even though I could end up getting shot. I'm gonna do whatever I can to help this person. The authorities, the ones who are supposed to be able to count on, show up, assault the good Samaritan and take his life. Just completely senseless. This is a person who was doing what every one of us would love to dream that we would do and lost their life as a result of it. I can't imagine a worse tragedy than this, JR.
Well, as you said, many of us would dream to be the person who has the courage and the ability to try and save someone's life in a traumatic, dramatic situation like this. But everyone's not like that. You said all of us would want to dream to. Some people dream of watching people die in the streets. Some people look at folks that are on the ground bleeding from like something like a gunshot wound and go, F that guy. And anybody who helps them, I don't want them helping him either, because I'd rather see this happen. There are humans out there in our country, apparently this guy is one of them, who would take some joy in seeing that happen. So much so that his aggression and his anger overtake him to stop anyone from ending his fantasy of watching something in real life happen that he would just love to see. He's like, no, 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 this is what I've been waiting for however old this idiot is. 39 years, I'm seeing it now. No, no, get away. Yeah. Now he's part of this entire situation. Instead of sitting back and hoping, maybe praying that the guy would die in the parking lot while someone's trying to save his life, instead he made sure of it. God, I can't stand these people.
I can't, like, again, he could have rightly been worried that he was in danger immediately after the shooting. But it turned out that the greatest danger to his life came when the cops showed up, as is so often the case. How devastating. And then on top of all this, an added layer of just, I cannot imagine. So state police have confirmed that they're investigating Vinyard's death. They say that they plan to talk to the center township officer, the guy who killed him, as early as Wednesday. This news originally broke like 2 days ago. The shooting was several days ago. What do you mean you're gonna talk to him as soon as Wednesday? You know, well, probably Wednesday we'll do it. Call him. Call him right now. Like, he's literally there. Like, do you not have his number? Do you not know where those cops generally congregate? Like, do they have a building, like an office? What do you mean by Wednesday we'll get around to it? He took a guy's life. Based on all of the evidence that we have, he resulted in the guy's death, and you're eventually gonna get around to talking to him? Are you not merciful?
Yeah.
Anyway, in the meantime, money is being raised for the funeral expenses for Ken Vinyard. I believe we have a graphic. If you search for that, it will show up. They're hoping to raise $25,000. They've raised a portion of it right now. Again, this is a guy who gave, like, not willingly gave his life, but gave his life just trying to help a person out. America desperately needs more people like this, and far fewer people like the cop who decided his role in all of this would be to brutalize the Good Samaritan.
Even if you think he's not in the wrong, they haven't spoken to him, bro. They should have had him on the scene talking to him about what happened. Yeah. Can you imagine being on the scene and doing that? Do you think the guy who shot originally, you think they're gonna eventually talk to him by Wednesday? Or is there a manhunt?
Is he like, okay, if he's on the run and that's why you can't talk to him, then let us know that. Okay, I can imagine if I had done a terrible thing like him, I might be on the run. But so far that's not, we don't know that.
For more political news, breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.